This is Kevin, a postcard guy here from Sarasota, Florida, with a What Sold video for the week of September 2nd to September 8th. I'm a couple days behind on this. We've been having quite a few sales, which I've been very happy with. So this is for actually last week, September 2nd through September 8th. So all totaled, I had 40 items sell for a total of $1,313.61, which I'm very happy with. That was above average week for me. $1,300 is pretty good. Sales over last year are up 61%. Again, I changed a lot of my inventory from this time last year. I'm focusing more on higher-end postcards. I cleared out a lot of my lower-end inventory and actually reduced my items I was selling from about 10,000 down to about 3,500 or 4,000 active items. So it seems to be working for me. 40 items selling, sales are up 61%. My average sales price has jumped up to $32.84, so I'm really happy with that. We had some smaller sales, but some really large sales, so they do average out over time. This week, I went to an auction format more than fixed price, so auctions brought in $790 this week, and fixed price brought in $525. So depending on the cards I'm listing, if I'm listing one-of-a-kind type cards that I can find no comps or anything like that, I will give them a try first at auction. If they don't sell during that first week, I will convert them to a fixed price at what I'm happy to sell the item at. Fortunately, this week, a lot of those one-of-a-kind type items did very, very well, as we'll see when we go through what sold. So let's take a look. The first item up is not a postcard, but these are those Denny mugs, the diner restaurant type mugs that we're all familiar with from the 70s, 80s, 90s, or later. I bought a bunch of these for like a dollar a piece. This one sold again for $14.99, and I believe I'm out of stock on these now. So that'll be the end of that. Next up was a scenic view of a rustic bridge at Liberty Park, PPAC, New Jersey. This card's been listed for some time. I'm very glad this one sold. This card sold for $9.99. And next up was one of the Indy 500 cards. I purchased a large collection that had a lot of auto racing cards. This was 1954 Indy 500 auto race. This card sold for full price, $14.99. You can see on the back it had Memorial Day 500 mile race. And that one was postmarked. This was a card here that was hard to identify, but once I did, it sold pretty quickly. This was a real photo postcard of the Perkins Mineral Spring Well, and it was in Albany, Kentucky, from as far as I could tell. The card was not postmarked on the back. It did sit for a little while until somebody from Kentucky came along and probably positively identified that view. That card there sold for, it was $34.99. It took a best offer of $24.99 on that card. These cards here are some California real photos. This one was an Oriental Garden in the Pacific Palisades, a real photo postcard. Unposted on the back, this card sold for full price of $9.99. Over here was one of my best sales of the week. I bought a bunch from this collection that had a lot of real photo postcards of pool parlors and barbershops. This one was especially nice here. Had all the people standing out front, had some beautiful signage in it, pastime billiard and pool parlor sign. You had all kinds of people standing out there with pool sticks, shoes shined, all kinds of things going on there. The neat thing about this is I had the interior and this card here of the exterior. Unfortunately, two different people got the cards. I put them up separately, hoping that the same person would get them. But unfortunately, two different people bought them. So I guess that's okay. This card sold for auction at $105.49. So anytime you can get a card over $100, it's a nice accomplishment. I'm very happy with that sale. That's really what helped me out this week was a lot of the larger sales. Here's a window in a pool parlor. And I believe, let's see, is this the same town? Yep, same town. So this would have been the display window at the same pool parlor. So here's an image of the card. You got these kind of creepy looking dolls holding pool sticks. You had tobacco across the bottom here. You had Turkish trophy cigarette displays. There had a lot going on in this view. This card was the windows display of Pastime Pool Room taken by August Hoyer, 5/23/1915. You don't get any better than that. This card sold for two bids at auction, $29.99, but it did not go to the same person that bought the exterior, which I thought was unusual. Over here was a real photo of an interior of a pool parlor. This one here had a man standing behind the pool tables. He had all kinds of signs hanging up above. He had shoeshine seats in the back. He had spittoons on the floor. There's one there. There's another one over there. And this is the pocket billiards. These had the mesh pockets where the balls would drop into them. You had tobacco case over here with all kinds of tobacco boxes. And you had a lot going on. This card was postally unsent. This one went off at auction, two bids, and sold for $41. The next one up was a college football postcard. This was not a real photo, but a litho postcard of the Syracuse University football squad of 1905. You could see it was postmarked 1907 on the back, had all the great football players in their uniforms, and most likely went to somebody in Syracuse that maybe either had a family member that played on the team, or they go to Syracuse now. This card sold for four bids and finished up at $22.50. The next card, I believe, was my best sale of the week. This was a real photo auto racing card of Hart Brochart in his race car at a Woodbridge, New Jersey Speedway. Anything New Jersey racing is very collectible, and this one is no exception. I had this card listed as at $149.99 or best offer. It had a great back on it. You could see it there. Official souvenir racing photo from the Woodbridge Speedway, Woodbridge, New Jersey. Races every Sunday afternoon. Nation's greatest drivers. Admission 55 cents, or you could sit in the grandstand for $1.10. So there's the driver with his goggles in the open cockpit. Again, this card I listed at $149.99. I took a best offer of $132.88. So again, another card over $100 really helps out your sales. Another auto racing card here. This was a real photo here of the Overland Bug car number 38. This was at Webster, Iowa. It was in 1910. You can see the early automobile racing down the track. You can see the starter stand there. This card was postmarked on the back. The original purchase price there of the card was $45 back in the day that somebody paid. This sold with one bid at auction for $24.99. Another really nice sale here. This was a 1906 World Land Speed Record. The driver was Dirac, and it was at Ormond Beach, Florida. This is back in the days when they raced automobile racing right on the beach at Ormond, Florida, right in the Daytona area. So you can see a nice early automobile, pretty much stripped down of all of its parts except for the motor and the seats and the tires and the engine. The card was postmarked on the back, 1906. And this card sold for one bid of $29.99. Another real photo auto racing card here. Auto racing on dirt track at Washington State. This card, again, it was not postmarked on the back. Had nice early speedsters in view. This card sold with three bids at auction for $23.07. Over here was the interior of a soda shop in Cobleskill, New York. This, again, is a real photo postcard, which means it was taken with a vintage camera. It was developed onto a negative and then printed in a dark room. And again, they had their choice of making just a plain old photograph of it or a postcard. And this one here was printed on a postcard back. So you can see the ice cream freezer there with the ice cream, all the patrons sitting in the restaurant or in the soda fountain, all dressed up having ice cream, which is interesting, in suits and ties. This sold for one bid of $19.99. Moving right along, this is another decent sale here. Al Waters General Store and Drugs at Kings Ferry, Genoa, New York. This was a nice old storefront. You can see all the signage there, general merchandise and drugs. You got a man with a bicycle. You got kids sitting in view. A couple other people. Kings Ferry was the name of the town, which is part of a town called Genoa, New York. Another man with a bicycle there. Just great signage, which really helps the view. This card was postmarked on the back, King Ferry, which is in New York, and sold for one bid of $24.99. Over here was a postcard store, which I really thought was cool, and a candy store. This was Lowville, New York, up in the Adirondacks. What I especially liked over here is right in the middle, it says Postcards of Lowville, which is great. All those things lined up across the front are all little postcards in the window. So he sold cigars and cigarettes, all kinds of sundries and candy, all kinds of things going on, probably husband and wife business. Look at the hot peanuts in the case at the front. He's kind of leaning on it. I hope you can see that. Let's see if we can make it bigger. It says hot peanuts, so it's kind of a peanut roaster out on the sidewalk. This had a lot going on for it. I started this at auction. It went for one bid of $49.99. Up next is a hotel and store, a real photo. This one was very hard to see. There's a hotel there, but it's terrible contrast. You can see the mountain range in the back, but not a great looking card. It was undivided on the back. It was postmarked. Like I said, the hotel was very hard to see. A little bit of foxing there. So this was $26.99, fixed price listing. I took a best offer of $22 on that. Over here was an unusual lighthouse cabins. This was a roadside up in upstate New York in a town called Forest Port. The neat thing was this was called the Lighthouse Building. Almost does look like a lighthouse in the shape that it's in. You can see the old 20s and 30s cars in view. And they had roadside cabins and a lunchroom and things like that. There it is postmarked on the back. You can see the cars. You can see the Route 28 sign in view. And I even included a picture of what it looks like today. And anytime I can do that, I will do that for them. It's seen better days in this photograph, but the building is still there. It still kind of looks the same. If you go between here and down to here, that is definitely the same building. This card sold for one bid of $29.99. Up next was a view of the Shakers at Mount Lebanon. The Shakers is the religious group known for their Shaker furniture in upstate New York. There's a picture of the Shaker building. Not much in view. And then on the back, it was not postmarked. This was $14.99. I did take a best offer, I believe around $13 plus the shipping. Over here was a roadside attraction in New Jersey around the area where I came from. This is a town called Toms River, New Jersey. This is Wild West City. It was a roadside attraction with fake, you know, storefronts of the Wild West. They would have shootouts and horse and wagon rides and things like that. This card was listed for a little bit of time. It was $12.99. I did take a best offer on that one at around $10 or so. Next up was not a postcard. This was a car-themed shirt. You can see it's just a plain old t-shirt. I pick up vintage t-shirts when I find them, especially if they're car related or concert related. This t-shirt was $19.99. I took a best offer about $17 plus the shipping. This is the last one of these. I picked up a bunch of these calendar toppers. I liked them because they had silhouettes cut in on of them and they had the advertising at the bottom. So this would have been put over the top of a tear-off calendar. This one here was $9.99, and I believe that's what it sold for, full price. Up next is another California West Coast card, Pacific Palisades. It was a view of the Oriental Gardens again, not postally sent on the back. This sold for full price of $9.99. This was the world's largest home mystery house. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but you can see it in view there. And this was a $9.99 sale, and it sold for full price. On the second page, again, we had about 40 items this week. This was a really nice chain-driven truck in this one. Photo of early chain-driven Mack delivery truck. This was not a postcard, as I'll show you on the back. But like I said, when they developed these in the darkroom by the photographer, they had a choice of either putting it on postcard stock or just doing it as a photograph, which is what they did with this one. So the same image as you would find, same image size, exact same postcard size, but it does not have the postcard division, the stamp box, or anything on the back. You can see the nice early cab over engine there. What that means is the driver would sit there with the steering wheel and it would sit right above the engine. Wood spoked wheels on this one. He was delivering bricks, so you can see a nice big load of bricks. There's the chain driven. You can see like a bicycle chain driving the back wheels. There's the men working on the back. I think what made this card here was that it was New York City, and generally I do very well with New York City cards. And this one was no exception. This was $34.99, and I did take a best offer on this one of about $30. Next up was another New York card. This is Long Island, New York. Bird's eye view of the railroad train loco yard with the turntable in view. So they would bring the trains up on this circular turntable, turn them around so they could head back out of the train yard and go on their way. So this card was postmarked 1908. You could see all the trains in the yard, the freight trains, the steam trains. This sold at auction one bid of $19.99. Next up was another printed card. This was a lodge up in the Adirondacks at Clayburgh, New York, which is in the area of Saranac, New York. Nice old little camp building. It was not postmarked on the back, but you could see it said Camp Downey, and it had that New York rustic stone look to it. And again, sold at auction, one bid, $9.99. This next one was an unusual card. I thought it might have went a little bit higher than this, but I'm very happy with the sale. This young lady is dressed up maybe for Halloween or maybe for some kind of party, but look what she's wearing. She's wearing a dress with two crossed pool cues and all the white little cue balls all over it. She's even got a pocket sewn in that would be used on a billiard table. So she's decorated as a pool table. She wears a hat, she holds a pool cue, she's got, like I said, the little white cue balls, and I especially like the pool pocket sewn into the side. There she is again. This sold at auction. I could not find any comps, anything like this, so I went with auction. It sold for three bids of $42. It does look like it was an international card. Anytime you see this on the back, a different type stamp box, you could see it says NW or Manor Park E or Stratford. This is most likely a British card or an Irish or English card. But either way, it was a great topic. And what a great theme. I've never seen a postcard costume or a postcard decorated dress like that. I thought that was really unique. So that one went for $42. This one here was another race card of a real photo, open cockpit, early Ford Model A, or early Ford model racer. You had the gentleman in the seat there behind the steering wheel, nice early automobile. It was a converted Ford into a race car. Again, started this one low and just went and let it go to see where it went. Sold for two bids of $27.99. Again, with the racing theme, a few more cards that sold. This is Hal Shoup, Hal D.O., and a special open cockpit racer. I believe this came out of York, Pennsylvania. All the research I could find, he was a racer in the York, Pennsylvania area. So he might have raced out of state, but I really believe this was a York, PA card. This card sold at auction, two bids of $19.99. Again, another race car here. Auto Racing Ohio, number 999. The Firestone non-skid Ford, which I thought was really cool. It had regards H.P. Taylor on the back, who was probably the driver. You could see the close-up of the car and the driver's behind the wheel. This card, again, had no comps, so I let it go at auction. Ended up with two bids of $42.99. Let's keep going with auto racing. Real Photo Auto Racing number 26, De Palma Race Car at Syracuse, New York. You see the early racer there on a dirt track. He's kind of looking back over his shoulder. I guess there's another car coming up. This card was postmarked on the back, sold for one bid of $19.99. This card here was a Bonneville Salt Flats racer, the Bluebird Bonnet, and was clocked at 304 miles per hour. You could see the missile-like car there in view on the Salt Flats. There were a couple comps, none exactly for this car. So I started at $19.99, and that's exactly what it finished for, $19.99. Another early auto racing here, 1907 view of early auto racing at Norwich, New York. So you got some cars speeding around the turn there. You got the crowd standing right on the sidewalk. No barriers, nothing to stop the car from going off the track, off the streets, and right into them. They were very daring back then. This card here was not divided on the back. It was an undivided card. Was postmarked. This sold for one bid of $24.99. This was an old moving truck, again, in New York City. I do very, very well with New York City cards. You would think with a city that large, you would have a lot of real photo postcards, but it's really not the case. This was a moving truck called the Glecker Moving Truck on Myrtle Avenue in Brooklyn. You could see all the advertising on the side of the truck. You could see the advertising, the street name Myrtle Avenue, BKLNYN, for Brooklyn. The card was not postmarked on the back. It had a lot going on. You had the Williamsburg phone number at the top. There's Fred Glocker's panel on the front. And I included a picture. This is what it looks like today. The moving company is basically condos or apartment buildings in New York. So again, if I can find the location, I always like to include a little photograph like that to show how much it's changed. And in this case, this was a storage building. You can see the storefront down below. All the upstairs were all storage units, and they were eventually somewhere down the line converted to apartments. So just a neat old view there. Moving right along, let's go to a 1944 World War II era postcard. On the front, it had a picture of Santa Claus with a little message. This was from a naval training station on the Great Lakes. This was from the Navy. You can see the naval person's name and address at the top, what company was in. Here's a message to mom and dad. It was going back to La Trobe, Pennsylvania. On the back side, it had the Christmas Day menu, what he was having to eat. He had some tomato bouillon. He had saltines and roasted tom turkey, boiled ham, giblet gravy, cranberry sauce, whipped potatoes. I'm getting hungry just reading it. Buttered fresh peas, celery sticks, olives, sweet potatoes, fruitcake, ice cream, cinnamon rolls, hard candies, mixed nuts, bread, butter, coffee, and even cigarettes. So come and get it, Santa says. I thought that was really cool. It was dated December 25th, 1944 at the bottom there. This one I put up at auction, couldn't find anything exactly like it. Went for one bid of $19.99. The next to last item was an old trade card. I especially liked it because of the birds on the wire. On the back, it had a piano and organ company in Warren County, New York. This was $19.99. I did take a best offer about $17 on that card. And the very last card of the week was a real photo of the crags at Estes Park in Colorado. And it was unpostmarked on the back. And there had a hotel in view down in the valley there. Big mountains in the background. This I had for $6.99. And I believe it sold at full price. So that's it for this week. Again, 40 items sold for a total of $1,313. I was very happy with that. Especially liked that my sales were up 61% over this time last year. And that my average sales price is still growing. It's been hovering right around $32 to $33 per card, which is very good. And I'd love to keep it at that point for as long as I personally can. So that's it for me. This is Kevin the Postcard Guy here in Sarasota, Florida. If you enjoy this type of video, please make sure to like the video. Give me that little thumbs up. It lets YouTube know that you like this kind of content, that you enjoy old postcards and seeing what's sold and what to look for it on postcards. If you take one step further, you hit the little bell icon, you will be notified when my next video is ready to be watched. I will be selling coming up in October if you're down in the Florida area. I'll be live on October 19th at the Sunshine Postcard Club down here in the Tampa, Florida area. So just click on any one of my links in YouTube. You'll see the flyer there. It's October 19th. It's a Saturday from 10 to 6. It's a nice little show here in Florida, and I'll be selling there live with a complete different inventory than what I sell for on YouTube. So again, hope you enjoyed this, and I really appreciate you watching. Thank you so much.